Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and put out an announcement. I got both you guys on there because you're both the last two that chimed in. And again, you know, for the News Ninja, I appreciate you putting out the word. Obviously, some of your fans are here, man. You know, it takes a lot to kind of break down egos and, you know, be willing to work together with other people like a lot of others have done here. You know, some people have kind of poo-pooed us just because we're not a syndicated thing. You know, we're not 100% confirmable, but we got real people here, man, and we're letting real people chime in, you know, from all kinds of backgrounds. And, you know, I'm proud to have you and, you know, some of your fans and other associates on the line right now. As of right now, we're floating around just over 40 callers. I'm going to go ahead and open the doors again and let anybody else who wants to chime in who might have just came on board, who's been sitting around for a while, if you want to press star 6, you can chime in and get in queue, and you can ask anybody any question or put any input. You know, let us know where you're from. Let us know where you're at. You know, we're trying to keep somewhat track of who's chiming in. We're missing some eastern states. We've got a lot of western states, some centrals, but we're trying to, you know, where the Carolinas at right now. You know, we're, you know, Idaho, where are you at? You know, a couple other groups. So if you want to chime in, that's great, especially if you're on anywhere near Ground Zero, especially if you're a local. I need you to press star 6, and I'm going to be watching for you, especially on those area codes. I just had two more people chime in, so I'm going to go ahead and open up the doors. Let's see here, 716 area code. You're in the queue.
Yes, Brian?
Yeah, go ahead, sir.
Yes, this is Dan Devlin. I'm a vice president of Oath Keepers in New York State. You had a woman on that expressed interest in donating. In fact, I think she donated, and she was wondering whether that was, you know, valid to donate through Oath Keepers. Just for information, you can go to oathkeepers.org, Stuart Rhodes, who is the current president and founder of Oath Keepers, has asked for donation to support the efforts of the Bundy Ranch situation. So you can go there, and as you go through the process, you can indicate that you want those funds to go to support the Bundy Ranch effort.
Now, let me ask you, sir, you've been a part of Oath Keepers for how long now?
I'm sorry? How long have I personally been involved with Oath Keepers?
Yeah. Yes, correct.
Probably 2 years.
And you sound like a seasoned veteran, sir. Are you also a veteran, or?
Right. You know, I'm one of the individuals that has both law enforcement and military experience.
You know, there's been kind of some conjecture and some negative feedback regarding Oath Keepers over the course of time. You know, I try not to listen to that, and I can only kind of go by what the group's actually doing.
Right.
You know, much like, you know, meeting a new friend. Based on what somebody else said, I can't hate on somebody, but, you know, I can certainly shake hands with that person and see how they treat me and only go from there, you know?
Right.
Based on where Stuart's at, I've been in contact with Richard Mack and his wife over the course of the last few years from, you know, past radio shows that I was doing, and I did some public access, and, you know, I've definitely had him on when I was Patriot TV.
Sure.
But at this point, I'm kind of a little frustrated with the feedback coming about Stuart Rhodes. You know, half of me wants to say, wow, you know, this is a real good stand-up guy. He's doing the right thing. But, I mean, are you familiar with some of the, you know, negative underground media attention that's been pointed towards him? And his affiliation with some, you know, I don't want to put out any conjecture, just his affiliation with other groups that might not have the best interest of the people in mind?
Actually, I don't know specifically what you're referring to, but if you want to bring it up, we could certainly talk about it.
I hate to point fingers, man, and I'm not saying, you know, that whether that's true or not. I just thought maybe you might have some feedback you might have heard. You know, the rumor mill spreading around bad news about Stewie, which I'm not trying to push out. You know, I want to believe with everything I've got that these are Oath Keepers that are trying to do the right thing. But, you know, there's infiltrators everywhere, man, and I'm not going to give anybody, you know, full 100% my trust, especially if I haven't been able to look them in the eye and shake their hands. And, you know, with all the conjecture going on, I just had to see if you had any feedback as far as those rumors go. And, you know, you're willing to help, you know, squash anything that's been in my head. And I'm sure there's other people listening that, you know, have probably heard some things about Stewie that it'd be nice to have dissuaded or confirmed, you know, but I'm just going to leave that as an open door. We've got a couple other people on the call. Is there anything else you wanted to appeal to, sir?
Without having specifics, it's hard to address it because, as you know, as you grow in popularity, there are tons of people who will, you know, put out all kinds of information. So not having any specifics, I'll leave that go. But I will mention that, you know, oathkeepers are some of the most honorable people, and this doesn't mean everyone in the organization because all organizations have people who are so-called on the fringe, and people often speak without really thinking about what they're saying, and obviously that can be bad for any organization, but their hearts are in the right place. They're dedicated individuals, for the most part, who are trying to do the right thing.
I agree on that 100%, man. I am not a paid member, but I've been kind of following the Oathkeepers group. I'm in contact with a few of the surrounding states myself, so you know, I'm glad to meet you officially and to have you chime in. By no means did I mean to put any negative spin on anything regarding the Oathkeepers. I totally appreciate what they're trying to get out as far as getting, you know, law enforcement, active duties, veterans, et cetera, you know, together to support their oath. But, you know, there's just been rumors, man, and, you know, when you hear about infiltration and other key groups that are really making good moves out there, you know, you just got to kind of try to keep your eyes and ears open and, you know, do the best you can, you know, based on, you know, experience, man. And I don't have direct experience. I don't have the opportunity to shake his hand. You may have. And, you know, if there's anything you wanted to, you know, say about that,
we speak periodically simply because of the distance involved. But individual groups in various states are trying to do the best they can. As far as I know at this point, he's been a substantial leader. I think his heart is in the right place. Oftentimes, you may be in proximity to people who you don't even agree with, and some people take that as an endorsement of what other people are doing when it's not really, you know, that kind of arrangement.
Exactly, but you're right, sir, and that's exactly why I was very treading lightly on that subject. You know, if anything, more of me was hoping you'd probably, you know, quash any rumors that were going on about him. But you know,
it would depend upon what the rumor is, and I don't think you'd want to bring it up, so I would say that if time permits, I doubt that Stuart would have any problem in getting in on this call. And if you have a specific situation that you're talking about, then it could be addressed. But if you just want people to go through any allegations that anyone's ever had, you know, it's
to be honest, Stuart has recently contacted me directly regarding a different venture. He'd probably be a little bit amazed that if he got on the call that he was talking to the same guy that he was talking about another issue with not too long ago on the phone. But if you could get him on the phone after 8 p.m. Central Standard Time later in approximately 12 hours, that'd be great.
We'll see if we can do that.
Yeah, if you can make something like that happen, I want nothing more than him to be able to speak for himself. You know, I'm that kind of guy. A lot of people talk behind people's back, and I'm seriously trying to, you know, tread this water lightly. I'm the kind of guy that wants to go to the source, you know, without spreading any rumors. So, yeah, I've got a couple of questions for him that I'm sure, you know, other people would like to have answered as well if they're, you know, I try not to entertain rumor mills, man, and I give everybody face value the best I can, and that's all I can do right now, but I definitely have a couple of questions.
I think you're trying to focus, if I, you know, understand correctly, you're really trying to focus on the Bundy situation now. Is that correct?
Yeah, for the most part. Again, that's another story tied to what we're trying to do here. You know, he's a leader, you know, and there's a lot of really good people that I've met, you know, along that path in that aspect or group or realm or, you know, however you want to categorize what the Oathkeepers do. You know, you've got a variety of 3%ers all the way back up to, you know, active duty and back down to just patriots that are watching that. And, you know, a lot of people that are being led in, you know, by what the Oathkeepers movement is all about. If there's conjecture there, I'd like him to go ahead and, you know, squash that during the remainder of these phone calls. Because he's obviously an integral part of the peacekeeping mission that we're trying to, to move forward with. So I'm going to probably not really lean towards those rumors, because if he wants to address anything, that's great. But I would keep it more towards, hey, what are you doing to get the sheriffs on board, man? What are you doing to get these active duty guys on the same page? What are you doing to get those guys to put pressure on these politicians right now?
And I would say that would be a good approach.
Yeah, and who the hell are these guys that are coming in with the last name Johnson, and you're apparently most likely don't even speak English, and you're taking illegal orders? Why are you here in our country right now? Why are you armed? And you know, why are you taking this man's land? Who do you answer to, and who does he answer to, and who does he answer to? And thus far, the fingers are kind of pointing militarily and outside of this nation. They're getting orders. You know, I don't want to play with conjecture and, you know, hearsay and conspiracy theories, but, you know, it sounds like a lot of people with a lot of money are trying to get their hands on American oil pipelines, American fresh water, and American precious metals and ores and things of that nature.
I see. Well, I certainly am aware of a lot of the things that you're speaking about. We try to stay focused on our current serving law enforcement and military people, and of course our objective is to have them honor their oath to defend the Constitution against all enemies, foreign and domestic. And I don't have to tell you about our domestic enemies that we have out there. You know, we want a nation of honorable people who will do what they promise to do, and that's our main focus.
I would like to throw this up in the air, man, just in case there is any law enforcement and things of that nature, and more oath-keeping type fans. You know, we've got plenty of guys that are showing they're a bad cop. What we really need is a lot of people showing that they're the good cop. You need to start calling out some of these guys, and I know it's frowned down upon besides, you know, inside certain, you know, groups and what's the word I'm looking for, cliques and such. You know, it's not always great to point out fingers at somebody who's totally disobeying their oath, because that's the overall consensus, is we keep that thing under our hats. And I'm, you know, fully aware of that. But it's really coming down to, do you support the Constitution or don't you? If you do, you need to quit screwing around. Plain and simple, because everybody's got their eyes on everybody else right now. You know, the military and the law authorities are looking at us like we're doing something wrong, when we know damn well a lot of them are doing something wrong. You know, if we know more about the law and we're following the law to a T, you know, there are certain things in the Constitution that support us unalienable rights, and we need to stick behind them and make sure that these other oath keepers are sticking to the oath they've given. You know, I'm a civilian, sir. I don't have formal military background, I can say I was raised by wolves, and a lot of them swayed me from the military because they had been there. I've never been anybody else's property but my own, and I have paperwork stating that I have taken myself back in you know, many different strawman type situations. And you know, it bothers me to know that everybody's going to tell you, you know, yeah, I take an oath to uphold and defend, but you know, there's got to be 300 some odd thousand soldiers from across the country that all know this is going on. And where are the guys that are upholding and defending, man? I don't see anybody defending that has a badge.
Let me give you some encouragement. I don't know if you know what's happening in New York State, but we have something called the SAFE Act, the Safe Ammunition and Firearms Enforcement Act. And you would be amazed at the number of sheriffs and law enforcement officers who have stood up and said that they will not enforce this act. We have legislatures in counties across New York State who have stood up and said that they will not allow enforcement of that law in their county. So
I'm going to ask you a question, sir. I need you to be real straight and honest with me. On a scale of 1 to 100, for you to be able to get Richard Mack and or
Stuart Rowe.
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, sorry. I cut out. And Stuart, if you could get either him or Richard Mack on the phone, well, on a scale of 1 to 100, 10 being affirmative and a 0 being negative, where do you think that you'd be able to get either or both of those gentlemen on in about 13 hours?
At this point, I have contact with both. But because they're involved in what they're doing right now, you can probably imagine that Not that it would be a distraction. It might be a very good thing for them to get on the call later this evening, you're talking?
Correct. In approximately 13 hours or so.
I will make that effort to get that to happen. However, not knowing what the situation is there, you know, whether they're meeting, you know, continually with people or what's going on, it's obviously their call.
10-4, in about 4 hours, they're going to be meeting at the flagpole if they're there already. We're just trying to find out, you know, who's on the inner circle. You know, are roads being blocked? Are they confiscating, pulling people over? You know, we need to further along our comms tree. So if there's anything that the Oath Keepers can provide, we've got a couple people that are trying to use, you know, secondary methods of communication,
sure.
Even resorting to CB radio down to ham radio. Mm-hmm. We've got repeaters that are trying to be worked on in a couple comm lines right now. Oath Keepers already have a lot of that and already established. If we could piggyback off of some of what you know, you guys are working on, that's kind of what we're trying to open up. You know, with you, I know you're on the coast, the opposite coast, if I'm not mistaken. So
right, and we're trying to determine now. In fact, one of the reasons that I'm on this call is just to gather more information and make a determination: is this the right time to head out that way, or is it better to wait? You know, we're not at the moment in direct communications with either Richard Mack or Stuart Rhodes, simply because we know what they're doing now, and it's no time to be, you know, deterred from what you're trying to accomplish once you get there. So what I will do is, I understand, and I've been on the call for a while now, but you're with the Sons of Liberty in Illinois, is that correct?
That's affirmative, sir.
Okay. And your name is Brian?
Yeah, Brian with a Y, and I'm online as Brian Free the People. The Free the People part's all one word. Okay. Pretty easy to find. Got a couple goofy profile pictures up right now, which I'll be changing soon, but just to kind of lighten up the mood a little bit.
Sure.
I'm going to go ahead, too, since I've still got you on. I'm going to add you to actually to the comms pool. We've got about a dozen guys. You'd actually would be number 12 that are working on that.
Okay.
You might throw you in a comms pool. You'd probably get contacted sometime tomorrow from at least one of these guys that have volunteered to kind of keep a comms tree open. You sound like you'd be an asset directly to the people we're trying to get a hold of. So, you know, with your reach, would you mind, you know, taking that upon yourself in about 13 hours to try to accomplish what you can and report back?
Sure.
All right. 716 area code, correct?
That's correct. You need the rest of the number? Or?
I wanted to verify. 716 area code, where do you reside, sir?
Buffalo, New York.
You said New York?
Correct.
All right, that works out. We needed more East Coast representation, sir. As of right now, your comms 12, okay?
Okay.
When you report back later, just kind of, I'm putting a star by you because you've got us associated with the Oath Keepers. If you could remind them, you know, in the mantra of the Oath Keepers, the main hashtag we're trying to use is for communication on Twitter right now is hashtag and then Oath Before Orders, which is, I'm pretty sure that's part of your mantra out there.
Right.
You are now comms 12, sir, and what was your first name again?
Dan, D-A-N.
Dan, like Daniel?
Correct.
All right, I appreciate that, sir. I've got you started on for comms 12. You'll definitely be contacted by either comms 1 through 5 in the next 12 hours.
Okay, sounds good. Well, you know, what I've heard so far, you're doing a great job and a great service, so I'm going to leave this call simply because there are other things that need to be taken care of right now, but we'll be back in contact, and hopefully we'll be able to get one of those gentlemen on the call later. Okay?
I really, really appreciate you, man. Keep doing the good work that you're doing on that end, and even after all this is said and done, I plan on doing this for other situations. I think I've got a dedicated conference call number that we're all using right now, so You know, keep
Okay.
that in your hat and give it out some more white hats, okay?
Sounds good. God bless you.
10-4. I'm going to move on. This person's been hanging on very politely, and I apologize for that delay, but you know, we got kind of involved in the Oath Keepers conversation. I'm going to clear the call and take the next question. Anybody else who you want to chime in? I opened up another Mountain Dew a minute ago.
Yeah, I'm in northern Nevada, Reno area, and I do not belong to any militias, never have. I want to know if my support be needed down there and if I could even get down there if I tried. I'm about 7 hours away, 400 miles.
All right, we appreciate you chiming in, man. I just got kicked off the call, so I'm back on. If you could actually repeat the beginning of that conversation that you were just having with yourself, everybody else heard you as well. I just didn't hear it, if you don't mind.
Yeah, I was just saying, I'm in northern Nevada, Reno area. I do not belong to a militia, never have. I'm just wondering if my services, my support would be needed if I took off and headed down that way, about 7 hours away, 400 miles. I'm wondering if I could even get there if I tried.
If it's, you know, not too out of pocket for you, brother, we could definitely use some more intel. We're suggesting that anybody's heading there to bring extra resources and come down to the peaceful protester. That is per request of the ranchers. Last time we were in communication with their door.
Sorry, I lost you, but I understood that that was a yes, that my help could be needed, just bring some extra resources for myself.
Hey, sorry to leave you hanging. I'm actually having some signal troubles on my end, and I apologize. That's an inconvenience for everybody else. We've still got 35 people on the call. If you could repeat that one more time, and hopefully I don't crash out on you again.
Yeah, I was just saying, I'm in Reno, Nevada, about 7 hours away by car, rough, 400 miles. If my services can be used down there, I'll take off and drive down that way. I'm wondering if I can even get through if I tried. Are they going to be stopping us on the highway, anything like that? You know, anybody said anything? And does the does the Bundys still want us to travel down that way?
You know, I'm not really one of bark orders, man. I'm just a dude that was on a conference call a couple of days ago that blew up into this. So, you know, based on what you're asking and what I, you know, would recommend based on what I know and where I'm sitting at this point, you know, I'm not barking orders, bro. You kind of offered. So what I would recommend is, let me ask you this. Are you in communication with other people that are much closer to ground zero by chance?
No, I'm not. I'm not. No, I'm not. And have not been. I have been trying to get in contact with the ranch to see if they would actually want my support, and I will head down that way. But I haven't been able to get a hold of anybody. I understand that.
I hear you. Do you have any friends or family that are in between, you know, where you're at to ground zero?
No, all my family, ranchers and stuff come from northern Nevada, eastern northern Nevada. So, no, everybody that I know is hundreds of miles away.
I gotcha. I mean, I don't know how many people that are awake and on the same page as you are, you know, in your network, but if you want to start reaching out to anybody, you know, that does have somebody much closer to that area, we're looking for trying to set up extra rally points until we have somebody at ground zero to kind of let us know, you know, what's going on that outer circle. As far as we know right now, you know, a couple of groups were arrested and released. Some people are speaking of, you know, guns being confiscated. So we don't really want to, I personally don't want to send anybody in there directly right now without having set up an outside rally point perimeter of some sorts. Preferably, you know, if somebody's coming from north, we'd like to have one up north. But, you know, 7 hours away is one thing. You know, if we had somebody an hour away, in, you know, from point A to point B from where you're at right now, and if you could, you know, head towards that direction and then give us updates and, you know, let more people rally from that vicinity towards you, that would be huge right now. If, you know, I don't know where you're at financially or anything like that, but if you want to maybe start calling around for any hotels northbound that are open and have vacancy, and maybe we can try to arrange something like that, you know, for people to start meeting at more of a public place, you know, that you can acquire once you get in that vicinity. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. All right, I will see what I can get together on this end and see if I can get some help to go with me, and we'll get her done.
All right, I recommend it earlier. Again, this is just me talking, man. I have no say on what you're about to do, but, you know, going as peaceful protesters, if you're going as a caravan, you want munitions probably in one separate vehicle and have them stay behind. And, you know, I don't want to set up anybody for failure, so forgive me, you know, if things turn sour, but I'm recommending, you know, you can take that with a grain of salt, but I'm recommending, you know, heavy munitions, you know, be, you know, placed in the trunk and sticking with the laws of Nevada. Hey, can you actually verify if somebody's carrying a weapon and it's in their trunk, they should be okay if it's all separated and nothing's in the chamber. Is that correct?
That's correct. This is an open carry state, too, so as long as it's on your side, it's legal.
That's correct, but we also were told that people that visually have weapons out right now, you know, are getting a little extra treatment, so to speak. So we're trying to recommend coming in as peaceful protesters, maybe leaving that in the trunk, so that, you know, you can get by checkpoints, you know, and have public servant questionnaires with you. If you actually Google search public servant questionnaire right now and the word PDF, so, you know, you've got a public servant questionnaire and then PDF in the Google Drop. There's a place called Scribd, which drops free downloads for these flyers that I'm recommending. I highly suggest you print out probably about 10 copies if you have that chance. Keep them with you, glove box them or console them, so that when, if and when you are approached, you need to be able to ask them, well, who are you? You know, I'm just an American that's concerned. You know, I'm heading down to go protest. Is that illegal? And if they keep questioning you, you need to hand them that document and start making sure they fill it out. It is every American's right to question who's questioning you, so you can verify that you want to answer those questions. So I highly recommend using them.
I will. I'll do that. Thank you very much, and I'll get off and let somebody else talk.
Not a problem. Wayne's still on. He's live if you want to chime in, brother. Anybody else that wants to chime in, you can go ahead and press *6 right now, and you'll be the next caller in the slot. And be happy to, you know, let you speak freely. As long as you don't, you know, really get out of line. I'm not trying to take anybody's First Amendment rights away, you know, while we've been having this conversation. But if you get out of pocket, I got to shut you down. Anybody else want to speak up, you can press *6 and speak your piece. Looks like just the three of us, Wayne and 8319, you're still on. Anything else you wanted to add before anybody else chimes in with the *6?
Yeah, I'm still putting out the information, still running it, working on a story right now, getting ready to put that out. But like I said, Brian, keep on, and I know, and I heard that you were just popping over another Mountain Dew. Well, you know, check it. You're going to need to get some sleep, too, now.
Yeah, I know. I hear you. I'm kind of on my fourth wind. Actually, Wayne, I'm going to ask you to do me a quick favor. We got Charles, 8319, you're still on the line. I've got another media person from Chicago that chimed in earlier, and I'm going to go ahead and add in one person. If you guys don't mind, I need to take a standing bathroom break because I'm starting to look like a koala bear over here. I'm going to go ahead and add a couple people. You guys can speak amongst yourselves for the next, like, 5 minutes while I go ahead and visit the urination station. Right? This caller, you're open, and 8748, you're unmuted. I'll be right back.
Dave. Yeah, Hey, I just want to let you know, all know, obviously, as a lot of you know, I'm the one that's handling the YouTube Google stream with this conference call going out, and we're at 43 viewers right now. We were at 50, so when Brian was talking about, you know, having, like, you know, 40 listeners on the conference call, that is plus the additional 40-plus that we're having here. So we're actually closer to 100 than not.
Okay. Is that, what is that YouTube stream address?
Well, the YouTube channel of mine that, I'm running it on is, Paradigm Shift Docs for You. That's D-O-C-S, the number 4 and the letter U. But the easiest way to get at that is if you go on Facebook and, you do a search for Cosmic Voice, that is a Facebook group that I'm affiliated with, that I'm running this through right now. It's actually where I originally got the number for this conference call. And if you scroll through the posts on the Facebook group, you'll see a post by Cosmic Candy Gallup, and it says, "Attention, calling all patriots, etc. Bundy Ranch." It's got the call-in number and everything. And if you go through the comments, periodically I post the link for the for the stream on this. It's titled Bundy Ranch Militia and Oath Keepers Conference Call. And it also has that same information in the description.
Okay. Good.
There's really no short-winded method I could really tell you to get at the stream. But I definitely plan on being around it at 8 p.m. if I can, unless something comes up. I'm really pushing to be around, and I'm going to be recording that stream out as well, because this is some really good stuff, and I don't know if anybody's streaming it out or what they're doing, but I think it's a good idea to have some sort of an archive. And, you know, if people want to use, like, Video Download Helper, which is a Firefox add-on to download YouTube videos and stuff, once this recording is done and, you know, YouTube processes it and it's up as a video when, you know, we're not live anymore, then people will be able to download that, and they can feel free to re-upload that to their channels without a problem. They're welcome to go ahead and do that.
Found it.
All right, cool.
Yep.
Awesome. I appreciate you looking out. I'm back, and I feel like a million bucks. I just did 20 jumping jacks. I think I'm on my fifth win, guys. I got another person that's trying to get in. I'm going to unmute right now.
Cool.
7396 area code. I'm sorry, last 4 digits. Go ahead.
I don't know if you heard me, Brian, but I got like about 50 people on my end viewing the stream, plus your 40, so we're actually closer to 100, just so you know.
Oh, nice. Wow. All right. Awesome. Appreciate that.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, there you are. Go ahead, man.
This is Anastasia Jacoby again from 2 Million Bikers of D.C. I want you to know I've been with you for about, 36 hours now, I think. I did crash out for about 3 hours last night. Your voice is just so lulling. it's a compliment. No, we do have, just so you know, we do have boots on the ground that we are getting periodic updates from.
Awesome.
And we do have some members that are actually on scene.
Feel free to get them to chime in. It means a lot coming from you, because I know who you are. But when we've got people here listening, it's really nice to have someone who's actually the one that's boots on the ground. I don't want to cut you loose. I want you to stay ahead of in this call. I'm going to leave you unmuted. Are you back on for the long haul, or are you going to need another break real soon, or?
I'm going to be on for a while. I'll be on for a while with you guys. One thing that I did want to say, and this was the request from our boots on the ground. The biggest problem is that they're having out there is cell phone reception. The cell towers are not taken down. The biggest problem is there's very few spots that they can actually go to get cell phone reception. The other thing that they were requesting, they said would be very beneficial and people could help with, is to contact the governor. from what they are understanding, the governor in Nevada, he is running for office. They believe it is rumored through the state that the governor might be taking on Reed in 2016 for Senate. And if he does that with a little bit of pressure, they think that it would be good for the governor to get involved, to say no to BLM, because he would then be positioning himself against Reed in the upcoming election.
And that is pretty important, you know, kind of to get another perspective of what's going on, you know, locally, politically, you know, how, you know, there's a power grab and a power play actually happening, you know, behind the scenes. And, you know, it's kind of interesting to get that aspect. Did you by chance have any reach in the political arena to where you might be able to get, you know, somebody like that to chime in tomorrow or, later?
We can try. We can try. I don't even know if we are friends on Facebook, because if they have to leave the area from where they're at to get cell phone reception. So if they're able to join in the call, they're not going to be able to sit on for a long wait period of time.
I am aware there's such thing as satellite phones as well, so if anybody's got access to that, you know, that's heading out there, feel free to get that up to the chain of command and some of the other power players and leaders that are there
okay.
So we can get some more reports of what's going on. Anybody else that heard that?
Okay. And another thing, too, that they had said that this was something that they were just talking with some of the family members from the, you know, from the ranch there, is one thing that nobody has really considered or has talked about in regards to the issue with the turtles. You know, of course, we know that's all been debunked. You know, the government has actually euthanized, you know, a considerable amount of the turtles. But one thing they said that people aren't realizing is the fact that the cattle are actually a part of the ecosystem. The cattle have been there for so many decades that they said to remove the cattle from those grazing lands would actually upset the ecosystem. They said that what would happen was the extra grass that would then be available would cause the rabbit population to basically explode. The rabbit population increases, then the coyote population increases. Of course, it wouldn't be a balanced ratio, and they said in turn, then the coyotes would eat the turtles. So if they were really concerned about the turtles, then they wouldn't unbalance the ecosystem.
Wow.
You know, that's just yet another perspective, you know, to kind of keep our eyes on. Obviously, we don't want that to happen, but, you know, for the most part, we need to kind of, you know, stick within certain boundaries to where, you know, getting a hold of the politicians, as we talked about, especially someone like that that's got more of the inside perspective of all avenues of not only the politics but the ecosystem, you know, obviously that's, you know, another part of the situation. I don't think that powers that be really are putting too much thought into the actual ecosystem right now. I'm still leaning towards more of, you know, commodity, you know, oil and ore and precious metals and water. And power and more room. You know, I think that's the focus of why they're taking the land. But by all means, you know, I'm hoping people that are there are trying to, you know, of course, still protect, you know, the animals and, you know, maybe find them good homes. There's plenty of zoos out there that, you know, not to say that that's, the best way for them to live, but it seems better than the alternative.
Right,
Leon, I've
right.
got three more people in the queue, ma'am. If you didn't, if you wanted to wrap up any other questions real quick, I've got three more people that popped up in the queue.
No, I don't have any more questions. One thing, you know, that I would encourage just for, you know, just another additional point, I know that we don't have a connection, but if we could find somebody or, you know, I know Wayne's crew, a couple of the other media outlets that are here. I know we're networking with several different media outlets that if they do have a resource to get a commentary from an ecologist, I think would, you know, possibly be beneficial, just add more to the story. And that's
absolutely
all I have. And again, right. And again, thank you for all that you are doing. It's a journey.
Hey, I appreciate you chiming in. I'm going to be killing this here in a few minutes. We're at 8 o'clock a.m. Central Standard Time. I'm expecting in approximately 2 hours they're going to be meeting at the flagpole at this ranch. So consider other alternative methods of media, right, you know, at that point to see if anybody else is chiming in out there in Facebook land and YouTube and whatnot. But I'm going to have to cut short, and then we'll be back in about 12 hours. I'm going to give out the number to play back the previous conversation and to get the code for that previous conversation prior to that, area code 559-726-1399. And for the last part of the segment would be #9676. Feel free to write that down. I'm sorry, #9676, and then press pound again, and you'll get this segment after we hang up here and stop recording. I'm going to let the next wireless caller go ahead and chime in. We still got Chicago comms. You're still on. That's cool. All right. I'm glad you're here, buddy.
I wasn't sure because I tried to say something, and it seemed like no one was hearing me, so I wasn't sure if I got bumped off or not. I was trying to say that I think Santilli has a satellite hookup down there for the phone, so anybody needing that might want to talk to him. As far as I know, that's how he's getting through, because he's been doing live video interviews on the scene, and you know, satellite is the only way that I could think of that he's doing it.
All right, yeah, you're right, and I appreciate you chiming in on that. I got a wireless caller, 7643. You're unmuted. Go ahead.
Yeah, hey, Brian. I just came across this. The Sheriff Gillespie of Nevada may have a financial motive for treason or betrayal of our patriots. He is the Nevada Commission for Homeland Security Finance Committee Chair. So that could be why he's not helping. And also that Santilli does have a satellite truck there. He was broadcasting and he was interviewing inside his truck. He does have a satellite van.
And he's on scene for sure?
He is on scene for sure. He's been there, I know for sure, since yesterday, and I think the day before as well. I've been following him pretty closely.
Well, hopefully he's also willing to help out some other people with that feed as well and getting things online.
Yeah.
Needs to be done.
And he's been, you know, and you've watched the videos too, I'm sure. He's been coaching the protesters. I mean, he's been excellent down there, excellent.
Cool.
He's a very knowledgeable guy.
I've watched what I could watch. I mean, I probably haven't watched everything, but every video I come across, I use Video Download Helper, and I download that just in case the corporate fascists decide to eliminate any videos, and at least I got copies, and those can be put back up.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and reset the forum. We've got Chicago here. You're still chiming in. 7396, ma'am, I still see you on the line. I haven't muted anybody out. I'm just going to give one last opportunity before I kill all this for the next 12-ish hours. If anybody else wants to chime in, you can go ahead and press *6. I'm going to give room for one more round of some Q&A. We've still got, you know, five people live on the call right now. Wayne, I see you're back in. All right, we've got a couple of people that just chimed in, so I'm going to go ahead and hit next question. It's going to pull a couple people off the line, but a couple people just chimed in that want to speak. So sorry if you get reset. If you want to call back in about 12 hours when we get this going again. But I'm about to hit next
Google, I can only record for like another hour and a half or something, because YouTube Hangouts have a limit of like a total of 8 hours, and I've been on for quite a while. So just letting people know, if the YouTube feed gets suddenly cut, that's why I hit the 8-hour limit.
All right, 10-4. I'm going to move on to the next question. Yeah, right on, brother. Did you want to speak up, or do you have anything to say before I cut to the next question?
No, go ahead, cut.
All right. I got a wireless caller chiming in 8947. And I'm going to unmute you.
Who waits for the donut?
Yes,
8947.
Yes, can you hear me?
Wireless caller 7643. I got to mute you for that one. Go ahead, sir.
Okay, have you got me?
Yeah, we got you. 8947, it's you.
Yes, this is Scott McGilvery. I'm a Logan County resident, also a member of the Logan County, West Virginia Sons of the Second, Citizen Action Committee, local militia, and stuff like that. Is there an account set up anywhere to where we can make monetary donations to help boots on the ground, or the restaurants we can call, or anything like that where we can help these people that are there?
I appreciate you looking out. I've got a map that I'm putting together of some people that you know, have offered different services and things of that nature. You know, I don't know what your reach is, sir. It sounds like you've got a good, well-organized group out there. If anybody's got some monetary funds, we're going to be setting up some sort of crowdfunding here in the next 10 hours. I have another person that is temporarily delegated via the Oath Keepers to get some research done on that and find out the best avenue and how to get that started. If you don't mind, I'll go ahead and hang on to your information and get you in touch with that person if they don't come back on here in the next call that we're going to have in about 12 hours. Are you okay with that?
Yes, I'm fine with that. I appreciate what y'all doing, and just know this is a groundswell, and it's going to get bigger than this. We need to stop all these totalitarian enactments, and liberty's going to reign. I'm sure of it.
Did you say Sons of the Second in West Virginia?
Yes, sir, I did.
Who is this again?
This is Scott McGilvray.
You are with Sean Atkins?
Yes, I am.
This is Wayne Dupree.
Hey, that's my photo negative brother. Hey,
Wayne,
good to hear from you, Wayne.
They are 100% real. Sons of the Second out of West Virginia. Solid patriots, and believe me, when they say that they're going to do something, they're going to do it.
Awesome.
Hey,
well, I'm glad you chimed in, man. We had dang near 30 some odd plus different groups, you know, a variety of different states chime in, and you know, it's good to hear you know, some of the dogs that have been around a while. We actually had Hutari on this call earlier, which was pretty awesome to hear from them. They've been laying really, really, really low since the last, you know, federal overreach and fraud. You know, those guys were completely exonerated for some petty yet shady words that were said. You know, Cohen, Protel, and infiltrators really set them up. I think all y'all need to kind of be aware that that's all over the country right now. And I'm going to
go ahead
and step forward. Wayne, I'm going to keep you on. 7396, you're still on, and 8947, you're on. Four more people just chimed in, so I know I'm.
Okay, I'll just say something real quick.
Go ahead, bro.
I'll just say something real quick, and I'll get off here.
Shoot.
Brother Wayne, just to let you all know that we've got a couple members that are planning to head out. I'm not sure who it is, but they'll be leaving shortly, from what I understand, to head out to Nevada. So we'll have boots out there, too.
How long have you been on this call, sir?
I've just been on this call for about 15 minutes now.
All right. If you could go ahead and keep spreading the word that we need peaceful protesters there, people not coming in BDUs, people not coming in balls to the walls. We don't want any hotheads, and we definitely don't need you know, anybody who's thinking about striking and striking hard. They need to look up the rules and the laws in that area so that they don't, you know, encroach on any federal type laws where they put themselves in danger. Don't come in locked and loaded, and you know, hopefully people understand it.
We got very cool headed members that do their research and do their homework. So I trust everything I have in my life to these brothers of mine.
I do too,
so,
all right,
cool.
I mean, I consider myself. I mean, I'm about maybe 6 hours away from the Sons of the Second, but I mean, I hang with them every time that I can get there. And as a matter of fact, I'll be there next month for their Patriots Day. But, no, they are like I said, solid individuals. And when they say that they're going to do something, and they're well-disciplined military members, former military members, they there's nobody finer. So, no, I agree.
Excellent. Excellent. Thanks for looking out, Wayne. I'm going to keep you on the line still, bro. I got a couple more people that are trying to chime in. Sorry if you're getting muted out. I only have so much space on this control panel, so I got to mute some people and bring in some people. And you know, nothing personal, man. I'm gonna go ahead and move on. I got an anonymous caller. I'm always curious what they have to say. Go ahead, anonymous caller. Your queue is open.
Hello. Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes. I hear you.
Okay. I'm going to be really quick here. There's a lot of rumors going around on Facebook, and this is one that I really want to confirm with you. This one says that the Arizona legislature is sending in official delegations to the ranch and that they're getting involved. It's a whole long letter, but it says that the they make it sound like the problem is being solved by these Arizona representatives, which it would be really nice if it was that easy. And is there any, I don't want to read the whole thing because it's too long, but is there any truth to any of this?
You know, we're expecting a variety of politicians, lawmen, oathkeepers, sorts to be at ground zero in less than 12 hours, but we're going to be cutting this call off here in a little bit. Would love for them to, you know, chime in right now if we could, but just due to some circumstances, we're going to have to re-chime this in about 12 hours. Hopefully the call trees and the CCOM that we have right now can get, you know, people need to be on the phone. Some more of the other leaders that are showing up, some more leaders that are already there. In a few hours, they're actually going to be meeting at the flagpole on the property. So that's kind of what we're recommending to anybody that is within the interperet at any of the meeting areas. We're also trying to set up secondary rally points on each side to just be a meeting point for people to, you know, avoid any, excuse my French, clusterfuck that's going on right now on the inside, because we don't have eyes on the ground exactly at this moment. You know, so if anybody here listening still got resources to people that are boots on the ground, we need you to get a hold of them and have them chime in. Go ahead, sir. Go ahead.
Hey, Brian.
Yeah, go ahead, Wayne.
I am putting up live stream to the to what's going on right now. It is from the Pete Santilli show. Right now it's kind of dark there, but it looks like a live stream going on via Ustream. So I'm putting it up on my website at raindupreeshow.com.
Excellent. You know, right now I wish I was an octopus. I've got CB radios, hams, VHF. I've got, you know, a laptop, a PC, and two throwaway phones, and a secondary phone. And as of right now, I think I've got all I've got in me. I'm going to close this down on the 30. We got about 14 more minutes. So, Wayne, I'm actually going to lock up the people that are free right now, except for the anonymous caller. And we're going to recontinue this in approximately less than 12 hours. I kind of went over that time frame that I expected I would, as you can tell. But if you don't mind, you can keep rebroadcasting the other things. But I'd love it for you if you wanted to chime in again at 8 o'clock or around 8 o'clock Central later on p.m. Hopefully you can do that. Last round of Q&A for a little while. I'm going to grab a couple more people. Candace, you are disengaged. 7643, you are disengaged. Anonymous, you are disengaged. And wireless caller in 1450, go ahead and speak your mind.
Yes, this is Michael Emery in Boise, Idaho, a member of the Oath Keepers and Health Establishment at the very end term with Stuart Rhodes.
Thanks for coming in, brother. What can you add to the situation?
Well, what we're doing is we're watching very closely. We have a second layer just in case it gets really really out of hand or whatever. And I think that y'all are doing a fantastic job. Got some boots on the ground there just in the background. It's just y'all keeping it peaceful, and we're watching very closely.